Good morning and welcome, millionaires, parents, relatives, and Gladiator Nation. Welcome to the 7th annual Gladiator Million Word Club celebration. We are here today to celebrate these millionaires and their passion for reading. Before we get into the ceremony, I'd like to thank a few folks. I'd like to thank Principal Williams for her help and support for our program this morning, as well as the Gladiator Student Council, who provided financial assistance for us, as well as the Goodwin Tech PFO. They also provided some financial assistance for us as well. I'd like to thank our language labs instructors, Ms. Sandin, Ms. Moore, Ms. Sloan, for all their work all year, as well in support of, for all their work all year in support of our students' literacy. I'd also like to thank our ELL instructors, Ms. Kelleher and Ms. Lopez, and Ms. Coar, who's our general department head, who basically coordinates and really kind of runs the literacy here in the building, and she does a remarkable job. She really does. Okay. I'd also like to recognize Ms. Kaufman, our literacy award winner from last year, and one of our retired instructors, language lab instructor, and came back to help us this year. She did. She's helping out with the T-shirts as well as doing the calligraphy on our certificates. Finally, I'd like to thank members of the Gladiator production crew for their hard work here today. They were working yesterday, this morning, they do a great job. They don't get as much recognition as they should, but they're here every day. They put the morning news on for us, and any special events that we have in here, they stream it live, and it's a pleasure to work with them every morning. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for all that you do all year long. And now for a few words from our principal, Ms. Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Varner.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. How are we doing today? Good. That's a good answer, because you're millionaires. You should be so excited. We're excited for you. We're excited for you. Certainly, when I got here, I thought, well, what is this Million Word Club? T-shirts and everything. And I thought to myself, this is a fabulous idea, don't you think, parents? Friends, you read a million words or more and more and more because you're here for 4 years, so that's pretty fabulous. I kind of wish they had a million word club when I was in school. That would have been fun. So I'll only just say a couple words about reading. You know, I have such fond memories because reading was just such a wonderful escape and world for me. My parents didn't have a lot of money and didn't have a lot of education, but I recall this book. It was called The Book of Knowledge, and it had pictures, almost like a dictionary, but like for young, like probably for elementary school. I don't even think I could read yet, like really read. But I would go through that book and understand as much as I could, the pictures and the words. And I loved it. I just kept going through it. And then once I learned how to read, which I can recall very vividly, I didn't want to stop reading. That was just the best thing. And so as I think about retiring, which I am, we're doing this year, I thought, now I can read again. Now I have so much time to read a whole lot of things that aren't just about school, but the things that I love, books that you're reading probably right now. So I want to congratulate all of you and your parents because they obviously support that. They support that you're a reader. So we're very, very proud of you. And congratulations again to a great group here. Thank you all.
Thank you, Ms. Williams. In oversight, I apologize for this. We'd also like to recognize one of our assistant principals who's here today, Mr. Darius Zunzik, and he's also, you know, he's also crucial, as well as Ms. Williams in the literacy program here as well. Just a thought, just a word or two before we go, or Ms. Sloan starts with the announcing of the students. You guys already have a leg up. The most fundamental skill that you need to be successful is reading. If you can read, you can do anything. It is the basis. You can't do carpentry, you can't do auto mechanics, you can't do any trade or any profession unless you're a skilled reader. So you guys are well on your way to very successful careers, whatever it is you choose, whether it's in the trade or not. You're already well equipped to handle anything that comes down the pike. If you can read, you can figure things out. And that's really what a lot of life is, problem solving, figuring things out. And your love of reading has given you a tool that's invaluable. And it's going to help you to be very, very successful. And now we'll have Ms. Sloan, one of our language lab instructors, with the names and the number of words of all of our millionaires. All right, let's go.
Okay, excellent. Okay, hello everyone. I just want to say I'm so honored that I get to announce all these students, and I'm so proud of you guys. So we're going to start with Anastasia Hunter. Anastasia read 1,930 words. Nice job, Anastasia. Next, we have Severick Marquise. He read 1,011,704 words. Nice job. Next, we have Aaron DeZamba. He read 1,013,640 words. Marilia Gonzalez read 1,025,791 words. Ethan Torres read 1,037,528 words. Next, we have Joshua Domina, who is unfortunately absent today, but we did want to recognize him as one of our millionaires, and he read 1,062,361 words. So, good job, Josh. Next, we have Julio Acevedo, read 1,085,162 words. Faith Chambers read 1,150,171 words. Caleb Gagne read 1,177,664 words. Gisela Cod David read 1,196,595 words. Did I say it okay? No, I'm sorry. We were practicing the last name. Colin Coyle read 1,228,287 words. Mia Hofton read 1,229,351 words. Alira made 8,706 words. Next, we have Priya Kambolia. 1,250,122 words. J- Joseph Glazier, 1,320,568 words. Julian Stepien, 1,426,988 words. Marcus Kadavid, 1,427,451 words. Ryan Cochran, 1,448,123 words. Angel Cologne, 1,502,409 words. Riley Stevens, 1,577,098 words. Morgan Nemethy, 1,580,786 words. Jack Douglas, 1,625,053 words. Kiana Hewitt read 1,629,138 words. Rosemary Hernandez read 1,656,735 words. Spencer Rucolette read 1,690,391 words. Enid Covertier read 1,880,674 words. Jasmine Racinos read 1,987,571 words. Thomas Douglas read 2,567,560 words. And our top reader, once again, Asia Viber, read 3,913,505. Congratulations, you guys, and good work.
Jenica, we're sorry we missed you.
Oh my gosh.
Let me get the words.
I left them up there. Yes, she wasn't on my list.
1,524,122. Sorry, Jenica. Wow, a lot of words, and they're not the final count. So I won't have the final. I won't do the final count until probably the 12th, when the AR and when all the AR stuff is done. So it theoretically, for many of you, it'll probably go up even more, by the end of the year. So just keep that in mind. At this point, we'd like to give out a couple of awards, and the first one is to our top reader, Asia Viber. I see Asia at least once a week, and she's always got two or three huge books in her hand. Reads all the time. She's one of our top students in the sophomore class. Three sports? Two sports. Soccer and basketball. National Honor Society?
Yes.
Not yet. You will. She's just an all-around really good student. And better than that, she's just an all-around really good person. It's always a pleasure to see her. It's always fun to have a little conversation with her. And we get to have those conversations and see her for two more years. So, Asia, congratulations. Sorry?
Did you get it?
That's all right. So, a million words a year, boy, that is, that's a tremendous accomplishment. Just a tremendous accomplishment. But when we started, when we look back a couple years ago, we realized that there were students who read a million words each year of the 4 years that we're here, which is really amazing. And we thought it was a good thing to recognize that effort. That's a significant effort sustained over a long period of time. So we wanted to recognize that, and we created the Hall of Fame, the Gladiator Million Word Club Hall of Fame. The plaque is on the other side. There are, I believe, four people in it right now. Five.
Six.
Six. Sorry. And this year we're going to add another one. Usually, as we see the trends with our students, that freshman and sophomore years are very enthusiastic, and we usually have high numbers, which we do today, of freshmen and sophomores. As we get to junior year, starts to go down, and senior year, it's even less. And usually, we've had two, but this year we only have one. And we'd like to honor Aaron DeZamba for his accomplishment of reading over a million words a year in all four of his years. Congratulations, Aaron. You good? Okay, congratulations, Aaron. I'll give you the rest. Nice box that goes with it. All right, and now for the last thing we're going to do, and I don't see culinary.
I called, Chef, they're on their way.
They're on their way, Chef, okay.
Sure.
Oh, an honor, that's okay.
I called.
Okay. Students, everybody reads, you know, for their own motivation, one way or another. We figure out why we like to read, and sometimes we don't even really know. But we here at the school, our job is to make sure that our students really kind of understand what they're doing when they are reading. We try to help them improve their literacy. We work constantly with our students to show them various skills that they can use to improve their literacy, improve their retention. And a lot of work goes into that. It's a lot of professional development, a lot of hard work that's gone into by the staff, particularly the literacy people. And so several years ago, we decided that we really needed to recognize that effort as well. So we created the Gladiator Literacy Award. So here's Ms. Kelleher with this year's winner.
Good morning, everybody. Congratulations, students. Way to go. Amazing. You are in for great things. Parents, way to go. They're going to maybe pay for your second home someday, because research says that stronger readers make more money someday, right? I have been asked to present this award, and I had to keep it a secret for a couple weeks, which those of you that know that I'm not so good at. But I've been asked to say a few words about the Literacy Award that's going to go to one of the adults in the building this year, and it is to my colleague and my friend, Dori Kowar. Dori is receiving the Literacy Award this year, and I can't think of anybody more deserving. Thanks to Ms. Kowar, our students here at Goodwin are reading every day. Their scores are improving constantly, and there is an overall passion for reading here at EC Goodwin Technical High School. Ms. Kowar is in many ways an unsung hero here at Goodwin. She is always doing what she can to stock classroom libraries with books, some of which she purchases with her own money. Not many know it, but it was Ms. Kowar who pushed for and finally got the 20 minutes of reading for the early homeroom literacy period in the mornings. And she fought and she fought and she fought until people finally said yes, and now we celebrate it every single morning. We have 21 minutes of reading. She worked tirelessly to figure out logistics, schedules, to train shop instructors about how to coordinate that and facilitate it, and to make sure that everything goes off without a hitch. And I have to tell you, if you were to walk in, parents, if you were to walk into this building between 7:35 and 7:51 every day, you could really hear a pin drop no matter where you walked in this whole building, because every one of our students is reading, which is a huge feat. She spends her 20 minutes coaching those students who are reluctant. Obviously not the students we have here, but we want, you know, literacy is a school-wide thing, and we have some students, if you can believe it, that don't like to read. Oh! But she helps coach those students. She finds them books that they can engage with, and that's not always the easiest thing. She's a coach, a literacy coach more than anything. In talking with my colleague, Mrs. Sloan, Mrs. Sloan also pointed out that she's she helps power users, so she helps train the most facilitated teachers in the building how to really utilize their strengths and empower them to even create even more success with literacy. She is the head of our literacy council and meets regularly about teachers and how we can improve literacy, not just in the morning, but throughout the building. She's in charge of data teams. She's always looking at numbers and trying to figure things out. And she creates AR incentives like breakfasts and donuts and stuff like that for the homerooms that win and for the teachers that win, again, sometimes spending her own money. So I am honored to present this award today to my colleague, Ms. Kowar.
I'm very honored and proud to accept this award. I'm passionate about reading, not only because it's my job, but because it's the key to the success for you guys here and for you guys out there in the real world. We have changed the Goodwin culture here. Oops. Reading for the last few years here, and I'm very happy about that. I may be driving the bus, but I have many passionate and present and past language lab teachers, English, your English teachers, ELL teachers, SPED teachers, Mr. Barner, and admin to support this. And that's how we've changed the culture here. You guys have changed the culture here for embracing reading, and I hope you kind of enjoyed it a little bit along the way. And parents who encourage your kids to read every day for 20 minutes. So in closing, I'll say a quote from the only one I can remember off the top of my head. From Dr. Seuss, the more that you read, the more you will know, the more you will know, the more places you'll go, and you guys are on your way. So thank you very much again. Thank you.
Oh, that was hard too. I'm not good at keeping secrets as well. And usually Dory and I have conversations about who's going to get the literacy award. And every time she'd think of it, I kind of put her off. Oh, we'll talk about it, because I knew a while ago who I wanted to give it to. Just wanted to say thank you to the parents and friends and relatives and guardians for coming, and it's really great that you came and supported your children here today, to your students. And guys, well, hey, summer's coming, week and a half, sooner for some of you. So why don't you go to the public library and get yourself some books and keep on reading, all right? Hey, congratulations.